Low-energy nuclear reactions have long been dismissed by many due to the varied results and anomalies reported across experiments. The inconsistency in findings has often led to skepticism, with critics arguing that such a diverse range of outcomes defies scientific coherence. But what if these seemingly disparate results actually followed a hidden pattern? David Nagel has examined several well-documented but fundamentally different LENR experiments and found a remarkable consistency. The dataset exhibits five distinct peaks occurring at the same atomic mass locations. This surprising discovery challenges the notion of LENR as a chaotic and unpredictable field, instead suggesting that there may be an underlying structure waiting to be uncovered. Building on Nagel's findings, it becomes evident that no single mechanism can fully account for the diversity of observed phenomena in LENR. While early efforts focused primarily on fusion-like processes, Nagel's investigations into LENR transmutation reveal a striking and unexpected commonality across multiple datasets: the clustering of reaction products around five distinct atomic mass peaks. This observation, derived from the works of Mizunu, Miley, Little and Potthoff, stems from diverse experimental methods. Despite variations in materials, techniques and setups, this structured behaviour points to a fundamental feature of LENR that transcends experimental specifics and suggests an underlying universal mechanism, one that challenges our current understanding of nuclear processes. The observation of five prominent mass peaks in LENR transmutation data highlights the emergence of preferential atomic masses during nuclear reactions across diverse experimental setups. What makes this phenomenon particularly intriguing is the consistency of these peaks despite the wide variety of experiments, methodologies, and researchers involved. To provide a clearer context, let's first delve into the nature of these experiments and their resulting data. The LENR transmutation experiments that revealed these peaks were conducted independently by multiple research groups, each employing distinct techniques and setups. Mizuno, Omori, and Enyoi performed closed electrolysis experiments on palladium rods immersed in heavy water under high pressure and temperatures. Their analysis, conducted using advanced spectroscopic methods like secondary ion mass spectrometry, consistently revealed changes in isotopic composition post-experiment. Miley and Patterson utilized a different approach, involving electrolyzed plastic beads coated in palladium and nickel in a circulating light water electrolyte. This setup allowed them to directly measure the production rates of new elements by comparing pre- and post-experimental concentrations, providing quantitative insights. Little and Potthoff used electrolyzed plastic beads coated in palladium and nickel, and elemental analysis were conducted via X-ray fluorescence techniques, which detected transmuted elements across a range of atomic numbers. Despite these experimental differences, including variations in materials, measuring techniques, and even electrolytes, a striking pattern emerged. Each dataset revealed peaks at specific ranges of atomic masses. The five peaks correspond to specific atomic mass ranges, each aligning with particular elements or clusters of elements frequently observed in LENR experiments. The first peak, light elements. This range typically includes carbon, a ubiquitous light element often detected in LENR experiments. The second peak, intermediate elements. Elements like sulfur and phosphorus may appear here. The third peak, transition metals. This range typically includes zinc and other transition metals like iron and nickel. The fourth peak, heavy transition metals. This range encompasses tin and other nearby elements. And lastly, the fifth peak, heavy elements. This range includes mercury and other heavy elements. The discovery of these mass peaks is particularly compelling because it emerges independently from the three major datasets, despite variations in materials, methods, and experimental conditions. This consistency suggests that LENR phenomena may be governed by universal principles or mechanisms that manifest under a wide range of circumstances. Rather than viewing LENR as a collection of disparate and sometimes contradictory results, the observed commonality provides a foundation for deeper understanding. The presence of five atomic mass peaks in LENR transmutation data suggests a nuclear process far more complex than conventional fusion or fission pathways. In traditional nuclear reactions, fusion typically involves the combination of small nuclei, such as the addition of a proton, neutron, or alpha particle to a base nucleus, while fission involves the splitting of heavier nuclei into smaller fragments. The clustering of LENR products at specific atomic masses, however, hints at a process that involves a combination of fusion and fission-like mechanisms, with the potential for both the breaking off of larger fragments and the fusion of heavier nuclei into stable isotopes. The dual process could be driven by localized environments within LENR systems, such as cracks, voids, or other structural features that provide the necessary energy and confinement. The initial conditions might create unstable isotopes of the metal, which then undergo a fission process that breaks them into smaller chunks. These fragments could then undergo further fission and fusion reactions, involving the fragments and other larger metal nuclei. These conditions may allow nuclei to interact in ways that are energetically forbidden in standard nucleosynthesis, producing stable products at the observed mass peaks. The structure of the atom appears to play a critical role in these processes, explaining why LENR produces such varied results. In the structured atom model, stepwise upward fusion occurs, but as the atomic structure grows larger, these additions can create instabilities. Unstable configurations achieve stability by shedding parts of their structure, resulting in fission. This process leaves behind larger fragments and smaller remnants, often carbon and oxygen. These smaller fragments may then fuse with one another or with larger chunks depending on local conditions. You might wonder, if such processes are possible, why do we observe only 5 distinct peaks instead of a broader spread of detected elements? To understand this, we must consider the role of the metals commonly used in LENR setups. In most experiments, palladium and platinum are the primary metals, both of which can undergo small stepwise isotopic changes, creating heavier isotopes. In some cases, these isotopes form unstable structures that undergo fission. The resulting reactions contribute to the formation of the 5 observed peaks. Additionally, trace contaminants present in these metals can also experience minor isotopic changes, which may explain the spread of products around these peaks. Thus, the observed pattern arises from a combination of small changes in contaminant materials and the fusion and fission process involving palladium and platinum. Let's examine each peak to explore possible pathways that might have led to their formation. The first peak. These are smaller chunks shed during fission, consisting of carbon and oxygen. The second peak. These can come from a variety of reactions, primarily from larger chunks which occur during fission. It is also possible to occur from the fusion of smaller chunks, such as the fusion of 2 oxygens to form sulfur. The third peak. These are larger fragments left over from the fission of an unstable structure. They are transition metals such as copper. The exact element depends on the starting material and its instability pathway. It is also possible that these can come from any of the impure metals present, which then may undergo isotopic change. The fourth peak. These products form from the fission of larger metals, such as platinum, which has undergone a stepwise isotopic change to an unstable configuration, often leaving tin or a similar element alongside smaller fragments. The fifth peak. These are possibly formed from stepwise additions to heavier metals, such as platinum forming lead. This pattern challenges the classical view of nucleosynthesis, where nuclear reactions occur in well-defined steps, adding or subtracting individual nucleons. The formation of isotopes at these peaks suggests a complex interplay of fusion reactions leading to fission reactions where larger and smaller chunks are shed during LENR. Such processes are unusual because they imply a level of nuclear flexibility and interaction that is not typically observed. In conventional nucleosynthesis, such as that occurring in stars or supernovae, nuclear reactions are governed by stepwise processes that add or remove individual nucleons. These reactions require high temperature and pressure to overcome energy barriers and are accompanied by significant radiation. In contrast, LENR processes occur at low energies, far below those required for traditional nucleosynthesis. The observed products, including elements at the 5 peaks, imply non-linear pathways involving multiple nuclear fragments interacting simultaneously. The absence of high energy radiation or significant neutron flux in LENR experiments further distinguishes these processes from conventional nucleosynthesis. These differences highlight the mystery surrounding LENR. How can such complex nuclear transformations occur at low energies? What mechanisms enable the fusion and fission of large fragments to produce stable isotopes without high energy signatures or traditional nuclear reactions? These questions remain unanswered, adding to the intrigue of LENR and its potential to revolutionize our understanding of nuclear processes. The clustering of LENR products at specific atomic masses invites a re-evaluation of how nuclear synthesis might occur under unconventional conditions. The interplay of fusion and fission-like mechanisms, facilitated by unique material environments, points to a nuclear process that defies traditional classification. Investigating these anomalies further could provide critical insight into the nature of LENR, offering a glimpse into novel nuclear pathways that challenge the boundaries of current physics. If you enjoyed this video, please consider leaving a like, subscribing if you're interested in more content like this, and if you'd like to help support the channel, links to my Patreon and other support methods will be down below in the description. As always, be brave, be curious, the truth is waiting for us. Until next time.